Hello, I'm Neil deGrasse Tyson, your host for Nova Science Now. First up, at one time or another, each of us wonders, how long will I live? 70? 80? 90 years? The average American lifespan is now about 78 years, but a few people live much longer, 100 years or more. They don't seem to age like the rest of us. Correspondent Chad Cohen met up with a few of them and the scientists who are trying to sort out why.
We don't feel old, we feel young.
We don't feel old.
There aren't many of them out there.
I'm 96.
97.
98.
How old are you?
101.
Only one in 10,000 of us, in fact, will defy all the odds and live the long, healthy lives that these folks have. What's the secret?
I really don't have any clue.
I don't have a secret.
You have to ask upstairs.
Well, down here, biologists are having a go, studying every aspect of these long-lived people to see if their elixir of life might be available to the rest of us.
Let's hope.
This is my mother, this is my father, this is the sister. Just
near Barzilai of the Albert Einstein College of Medicine in Bronx, New York, has worked with this genetically distinct population of Ashkenazi Jews for the last 8 years, wondering, what do they have that the rest of us don't?
They're born in the early 1900s. Many children are dying in epidemics of childhood diseases, so they survive already that. And then they get to middle age, and there are all the middle ages diseases. There's the cancer and the cardiovascular, and they don't get touched by that. And then they have to survive getting to 100. It's an incredible journey against odds.
It wasn't really milk and honey, my life, but here I am.
But none of them have exactly been following doctor's orders.
I would say the opposite.
Every day, French fries.
Roast beef.
You can drink, but no mixed drinks, just scotch.
There's no yogurt eater, there's no vegetarian.
46 years of cigarette smoking.
Yeah.
And you're 101 years old.
I'm still 101.5 years old.
All the things that we tell our patients to do, they didn't do, and it didn't bother them. They got there anyhow.
Do you feel lucky that you've lived as long as you have?
Of course.
They did have help, though, as Barzilai discovered.
There's an unusual history of longevity in their family.
The younger sister of my father was 98, and my mother was 92.
I still have an aunt. My mother's side of the family is alive. She's 101.
This is a picture of my husband and this huge kiss. After that, we got married.
My gosh.
It's a wonderful
Something
picture.
Very special was protecting them from the environment and their own excesses.
We have good genes. We owe it all to our mother and father.
And when the team peered into their blood, it became clear what it was.
The initial thing that was striking is that we're many, many people in the study had very high HDL cholesterol. HDL cholesterol is the good cholesterol.
Good, because it cleans up our blood vessels by schlepping the bad cholesterol away. So the more the merrier. But something else was going on with the HDL cholesterol.
We saw that they're amazingly large with our centenarians.
It seems the bigger the HDL, the better. Perhaps because bigger HDL hauls away more bad stuff than smaller HDL does. 60% of the centenarians had these larger HDLs.
So this became a major marker of exceptional longevity and also directed us to several of the genes that we tested.
Barzilai smeared our centenarians' DNA onto chips loaded with cholesterol genes.
This chip contained 500,000 variations that humans can have on their DNA.
Barzilai found that three particular mutations in three different genes distinguished many of their DNA from the general population. And all those changes play a role in making HDL bigger and protecting against age-related disorders like diabetes and cardiovascular disease.
So then we feel more comfortable in saying, you know what, this is a longevity gene.
The idea of a small number of longevity genes flies in the face of scientific wisdom, which has long held that aging involves hundreds, even thousands of genes all running amok.
Show me wild type versus knockout.
But that's never sat well with MIT's Leonard Garenti, thanks to one bizarre, but confirmed finding. Cut just about any organism's food supply by 30 to 40%, and it will live up to 50 to 60% longer.
If aging is complicated, multifactorial, so on and so forth, how could a simple dietary change make an organism live longer?
To find out, Garenti started simply with a simple organism, baker's yeast, the stuff of beer and bread. In their brief lifespan, about 2 weeks, yeast cells typically divide a total of 20 times. Every once in a while, though, a yeast lives longer than that, dividing, say, 25 or 30 times. Those are what Garenti looked for, the yeast equivalent of our centenarians. Well, it took them about 8 years, but Garenti's group finally found that these long-lived yeast also have life-extending mutations in their DNA, in a specific family of genes called sirtuins. Yep, genes have names too. Delete the most powerful of these genes, called SIR2, from a yeast cell, and it will die earlier. Add extra copies back in, and it will live up to 50% longer.
Okay, we know this gene is important for countering aging, but what does the gene do?
Well, sirtuins, as the scientists soon discovered, are part of an intricate stress response. When times are tough, they kick an organism into survival mode to beef up DNA repair or stop cells from dying. And it turns out, nothing sets these sirtuins into action, like a shortage of food.
And that's why our finding with SIR2, I thought, was an epiphany, because it gave a possible explanation for how a reduction in calories in the diet could be equated with a long life.
And I don't think it's a high.
People have sirtuin genes too, although we don't know how important they are yet. But the more these scientists experiment in yeast, and then in worms and flies, the more they realize how vital this calorie sirtuin connection is. David Sinclair, once a postdoc in Garenti's lab, now runs his own at Harvard Medical School.
What my lab and others have found is that when you get rid of the SIR2 gene, the diet doesn't work anymore.
So put them on a calorie-restrictive diet, they live longer. Take away this gene, put them on the same diet, they don't live longer.
Exactly.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing as that sounds, sirtuins aren't the only genes that do this.
Yes, but also just...
For more than a decade, Cynthia Kenyon of the University of California, San Francisco, has been making these microscopic worms called C. elegans live far longer than believed wormly possible.
You just change one gene and the whole animal is fine. It's incredible.
By damaging a single gene, this one's called DAF2, these worms live twice as long. DAF2 helps make insulin work. When it's mutated, you get less insulin. And that brings us back to calorie restriction, because it has the same effect.
You limit food intake, that leads to a decrease in the level of insulin, so that should lead to lifespan extension.
It turns out low insulin levels kick on survival genes too, just like the sirtuins. So by damaging DAF2, the wormly life is longer.
You can see why they call it elegans. They're very beautiful.
Right, right.
These squiggly, squirmy guys are about 4 days old. But in 2 weeks?
They look terrible. They're in the nursing home. Right. They look like they're falling apart. Their heads are moving, barely, but that's it. And now, prepare yourself for something amazing. This is the mutant worm. We changed just one gene, the DAF2 gene, at that same age. And you can see, it's moving around. It looks great. It's equivalent to looking at someone that's 90 and thinking that they're 45.
And the best part, when the equivalent genes were tweaked in flies and then in mice, their healthful properties were also preserved.
These long-lived animals are resistant to a whole range of age-related diseases. The worms have muscle deterioration that happens later. The fruit flies are more resistant to heart failure. The mice are more resistant to cancer. This is a whole new way of thinking about disease, a whole new way.
Maybe.
But hold on a minute. If all this research is so tied to cutting calories, how do we explain these guys?
I always had breakfast. I always had lunch.
I eat whatever I like, and I do what I like.
It could be that they have different variants of these longevity genes, allowing them to experience the effects of calorie restriction without really having to do the diet.
So what about the rest of us then, who may not be so blessed? Can we live longer by eating less? Well, it's not proven in people yet, but the answer to many scientists is probably, if we eat a lot less, 30 to 40% less to be exact, which means the food someone like me might take in a day would shrink from about 2,500 calories to 1,500 calories. Hey, it's no fun, but people do it.
I did try calorie restriction for about a week and gave up. It's not a pleasant way to exist.
Perhaps it was pangs of hunger that led David Sinclair towards his next venture, finding drugs that offer the benefit of calorie restriction without the drastic diet. He's off to a good start. Sinclair found that resveratrol, the molecule that has been touted to make red wine healthful, stimulates the sirtuin genes and allows everything from yeast to worms to flies to live 30 to 40% longer. And it's looking good for mice.
Those are the G's. You have to do the B's now, right? Okay.
Barzilai, Garenti, and Kenyon are also seeing their gene targets make their way into the pharmaceutical arena.
I'm hoping that within my lifetime we'll see the benefits of this research. Being very optimistic, we could see these in the next 5 to 10 years.
That'd be wonderful.
In the meantime, none of the scientists are exactly waiting around for this to happen.
I eat a diet that is predicted to keep my insulin levels lower.
I don't calorie restrict, but I don't gorge myself.
I drink more red wine than I used to.
My HDL is good because I'm taking two different drugs to increase it.
Would you recommend living this long to everyone?
Why not?
Yes.
Of course. Yeah, life's wonderful.
But I am 110. I want to see you here again.
It's a date.
You shake hands with me?
I'll shake hands with you.
Okay.
It's a date.
You're watching Nova Science Now.